take five. Back it goes. Ulisi has it. And the Rebels charging towards the line. Comes back for Genia. Leads a runner. Finds Hodge. Can't sneak through this time, like he did in the first half. But it's still there for the Rebels, and no, we're going to have a scrum. Not coming out of there. So we've got one of the Rebels players down.
We've got more than one. And there's a bit of pain there too.
Is that Murphy?
So. I think it is Amanaki Murphy, that number eight.
Yep.
Well, there he is there. So he got crushed as it went. It went to the sideline. He realised he was going to hit the sideline. Went down, didn't hurt himself there. Oh, no, he held himself in midfield.
I think,
Matt Lucas.
I think it might be a little...
hitting?
A little, just a little something there from Matty Lucas.
He's one of the toughest players on the field. So what? Murphy's gone here. Oh, he's punched him in the chest. Come on.
And he was taking exception to the fact that Murphy was holding on to it.
That's gamesmanship. He's hoping that they check the big screen and wonder how he got hurt. He's playing for a penalty here. I don't like that.
11-1. Alan Alatoa, who limped off the field a short time ago, is back out there because they're down at front rower.
Murphy do this last week as well. Wonderful player. Have a look.
Get up.
So White Six, you're now captain. You set a standard, please. Thank you.
Nonsense after the whistle, all the time.
Yep. We're going to reset it, okay? Thank you. So Tom, we did talk in the first half about guys running in and pushing it. Clear message to 2 and 8 for you now, okay?
Hey, Jordan. George, if you do that again, you're off.
There's plenty of spite.
Thank you.
Wish there was more rugby, though.